I will quickly revise what we have done in the last lecture. That is, we studied linear queue and the implementation of linear queue using array. What is the drawback of linear queue? Can anyone tell me? What is the drawback of linear queue? Tushar has given me the answer, that is space is wasted. In linear queue, insertion is done from the rear end and deletion is done from the front end. And whenever the rear pointer reaches to the last index of the array, you can say the rear variable reaches to the last index of the array or the queue, then we can say that the queue is full and we cannot insert further elements into the queue. Assume that there are five locations into the queue. It means the queue can accommodate only five elements like this. In the diagram, you can see it is a queue of five elements. So front is pointing to the first index of the queue, whereas rear is pointing to the last index of the queue. In this diagram, I can say that the queue is full. All the five locations are filled with the elements. So we can say that the linear queue is full. Now I try to delete some elements from this linear queue. If I delete the first element, the first block becomes empty and the pointer shifted, the front pointer shifted to the next element, immediate next element, that is 20. Now if I delete 20 also from this queue, then the front pointer is shifted to 30. It means the front element becomes 30. Front pointer is pointing to 30. Whereas 10 and 20 have been deleted from this queue. We can easily say that there are two blocks empty. We can insert two more elements into this queue. But it is not possible because in linear queue, the insertion is done from one end, another rear deletion is done from another end, and that action happens only once with the element. So here you can't go back in the location 0 and location 1, first location and second location of this queue. You can't go back. You can go only in forward direction. You can move only in one direction. Here you can see that the front pointer is pointing to 30, whereas rear pointer is pointing to 50. Only three elements are there. The queue size was 5, but still we are not able to insert the next new element into this queue because the rear is pointing to the last element of the queue. It is full. It is showing that the queue is full. We can't insert. This is the drawback. Memory gets wasted. Right. Then what to do? In linear queue, the traversal through the queue is possible only once. Once an element is deleted from the queue, we cannot insert another element in that position. This disadvantage can be overcome by the another queue, another type of queue called as circular queue. Now we'll see what is the definition of circular queue. How it looks like? Even circular queue is also a linear data structure which follows the principle of first in, first out, FIFO. The principle of queue is as it is. It also follows FIFO rule of queue, that is first in, first out. But instead of placing the elements linearly, one after the another in a line, they are placed in a circular fashion. It means that the last index of the array immediately follows the first index of the array. So if you see in the diagram below, this is one example of a circular queue. All the elements are placed one after the another in circular fashion. The arrangement is in a circle. That's why such a queue is called as circular queue. If you place all the linear queue elements in a circular fashion, then that queue can be considered as a circular queue where the last element of the queue immediately follows the first element of the queue. So in this diagram, it's a queue of eight elements, okay, where the front and rear pointers are pointing to the same location. When the queue is empty, both the pointers point to the same location in the queue. then we can say that the queue is empty. Here the indices are given from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 7 is the last index. And this 7 index element immediately follows the 0th index of this queue. That means that the last element immediately follows the first element of the queue. That's why such a queue is called as circular queue. We'll see the implementation of circular queue using array. Now, what are different operations we can perform on circular queue? We can perform all the operations that we performed on a linear queue. We can also perform those operations on circular queue. What are those operations? The first is enqueue operation. Enqueue operation means inserting an element inside the queue. Inserting an element in the queue is called as enqueue operation. And whenever we enter any value in the queue, we always increment the pointer rear by 1. We increment rear pointer by 1. Now the another operation is dequeue operation. What we do in dequeue operation, we delete an element from the queue, and always the element which is at the front of the queue is deleted. Whenever the element is deleted from the queue, the front pointer has to be incremented by 1. This is the principle of linear queue, which is also followed by circular queue. Then the last operation is display operation. All the elements of the queue are displayed in the same order of their insertion. Again, it is same in terms of circular queue as well as linear queue. There is a slight difference between circular queue and linear queue is that in linear queue, we can't go back, whereas in circular queue, we can go back and we can insert the new element in the space available inside the queue. There is one formula that we are going to use in circular queue. I already spoken about that formula in the last lecture. That is, instead of incrementing rear pointer by just by 1, I will increment the rear pointer by 1 by a formula. I am writing the formula here in the notepad. Just instead of writing rear equal to rear plus 1, that we do into the linear queue, we are going to perform here rear equals to rear plus 1 mod max size. What is this max size? It is the size of the queue. It is the size of the queue. This formula not only increments the rear pointer by 1, but also keeps your rear pointer in circular fashion. It moves the rear pointer in circular fashion. I'm using the word pointer. It is just a variable. It is a normal variable in terms of array implementation. So rear will be incremented by 1 in circular fashion. Then there is another formula that we are going to use in this program. That is front equals to front plus 1 mod max size. Again, this formula also increments front pointer by 1. But the advantage of using this formula is that it not only increments front pointer by 1, it also keeps the front pointer in a circular fashion. It moves front pointer in circular fashion. To understand this, we will see the program and we'll check how it works. The code of the circular queue is somewhat similar to linear queue, only there are certain lines of changes, like the formula that we have checked before. We are going to use the formula to increment rear pointer by 1, to increment front pointer by 1 in the enqueue and dequeue operation respectively. So here, if you see the first three lines, these are standard lines that we write in most of the programs. That is hash include stdio.h, then hash include standard library.h, then hash define max file. It is the size of the queue. Then this structure is, how do you define a structure is very important. See, this is the structure for circular queue. We need an array. We need two pointer variables. That is, we need two variables. So that is front and rear. Integer max of x of max is the circular queue. And small q is the queue variable by which we can access the front, rear, and x, that is the array. And we know how to access those elements. We'll see in this program. After that, immediately I am declaring all the operation that we are going to perform in this program. There are three operations we are going to perform. NQ, another is DQ, and third is display. Okay. Then I am declaring some variable here, that is integer n. N is the number that you want to insert into the queue. Then count equals to zero. Count equals to zero. I have taken this variable to avoid the conflict between the empty condition for circular queue and the full condition for circular queue. I'll tell you when this conflict arises. This count variable is we are going to use to solve that conflict. After that, in the main program, I'll declare some more variable, that is I and k. I is for for loop purpose, you can say, and k is the choice. So I have declared all the variable that we have declared in previous programs also, but only one variable is more in this program, that is count. Count equals to zero. So this is going to help us to resolve the conflict between the empty condition for circular queue and full condition for circular queue. Then immediately on the next line, we'll show a menu card to the user. What we are going to perform in this program, a menu card will be displayed to the user. NQ, one is NQ, two is DQ, three is display, and fourth option is exit. Once it is done, we will assign Q dot front equal to zero or Q dot rate equals to zero. Both are zero, or we can assign both are minus one also. So whenever both the pointers are the same location, we assume that the circular queue is empty. So in this program, I assign q dot front equal to minus one, q dot rear equals to minus one. When q dot rear is at minus one, there is nothing in the queue. Queue is empty. Linear queue is empty as well as circular queue. You can say circular queue is also empty here. When both the pointers, front and rear pointers, pointing to the same location, then we can say that it is empty. Front equals to minus one, rear equals to minus one is the empty condition for circular queue. In some books, it is mentioned that front equal to zero, rear equals to zero is the empty condition. That is also true, because whenever both the pointers are at the same location, we assume that the circular queue is empty. Now, just imagine the circular queue as mentioned in the above diagram, and we'll apply this. Assume that the front and rear pointers here are both are pointing at zeroth location. Both are at zeroth pointing to minus one. Sorry, they are both are pointing to minus one. It means the circular queue is empty. Now try to insert the first element, that is 10. What will happen? 10 will be placed at index number zero, where front is equals to minus one only, but rear is incremented by one now. Front is minus one, rear is at zero. When you insert next element, it goes into the index number one, that is 20, say. Next will be placed at index number two, the value is say 30, and so on. Go on inserting till seventh block, seventh index. So how many elements were inserted? 10 20 30 40 50 60 70 and 80. It means that the last value that we have inserted in the seventh block was 80. And that time your rear pointer is at 7, right? Rear was pointing to index number 7. Where was your front pointer that time? It is at minus 1 only. Can we say that your circular queue is full here? When there are all the elements filled inside the circular queue, we can say that the circular queue is full. Otherwise, it is not full. We can insert further more elements into the queue. Now, try to perform DQ operation on this. What will happen? We'll see. Your front pointer was at minus one. Assuming that the circular queue is full in this case, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, and 80 is the last block, which is index number 7, right? Now you are performing DQ operation. When you perform DQ operation, front has to be incremented by one. So front is now pointing to zero, and we said that the first element is deleted, that is 10. Next, when it points to 1, 20 gets deleted. When it points to 2, next element gets deleted. When it points to 3, next element is deleted. Like this, when it points to 7, the last element is also deleted. When the last element was deleted, again your circular queue becomes empty, but both the pointers are at index 7. They are at index 7. Okay. When both the pointers are at the same location, we can say that the circular queue is empty. I will go to the program and we'll check the code of NQ operation. So here you are seeing how to display menu card and to initialize the empty condition for circular queue. See, inside the while loop, this is a standard template that we have used in the previous programs also. While one means always true, it means it is an infinite loop. Inside that, we are asking a user to enter a choice. It means the operation can be executed n number of times as per the choice of the user. So here we are taking the choice from the user. If the choice is entered by the user is 1, in the switch case, it jumps to case 1 and it performs NQ operation. It completes NQ operation. On the next line, there is a break statement. It exits from the case 1. If the choice is 2, it goes to DQ operation. It called DQ function. In the background, it completes DQ function, and when it comes to break, it exits from the case 2. If it matches to case 3, say, if the option entered by the user is 3, then it executes display function, and then it exit from the case number 3 when it reaches to break. In case 4, we are going to call exit function because we want to stop the program. Fourth option is for stopping the program. And the last line that we have in a switch case is default statement. It will be executed only when the wrong choice have been entered by the users. Any choice apart from the available choice, like if the choice entered by the user is more than 4, like 5, 6, 7, 8, if he enters, then it is a wrong choice and it will show you a message that please enter a valid choice. Now we'll move to the NQ function, how NQ function is written. This is very, very important. Let's go. In NQ function, as soon as we enter, we'll check first the queue overflow condition. The same way we did it into linear queue. How to check queue overflow condition here? I'm using a counter variable. If the count is max, the size of the array, we can say that the circular queue is full. Else, we'll ask the user to enter the element that he wants to enter into the circular queue. Insert the element into circular queue, and the element we are going to ask to the user, enter an element to be inserted. With the help of this scanf statement, we'll read it. Now see here, only one line changes. In linear queue we used here is q.rear equal to q.rear plus 1. Here we are doing the same thing with another formula, that is q.rear equals to q.rear plus 1 mod max is the size of the queue. And then once the queue rear point is incremented by 1, at that particular location q.x of q.rear equals to minus q.rear equals to n. It means we are assigning the value of the variable at this particular queue location, queue rear location. As soon as the value comes into the queue, we have to immediately increment the counter by 1. So I incremented counter by 1 here. How many times this code will be executed? It allows you to do NQ operation. In this program, it allows you to do NQ operation 5 times because the size of the queue mentioned in the program was 5. Okay. Now, assuming that our queue is empty initially, there is nothing inside the queue, then how this code will going to execute? We'll do the hand run now. Initially, assume that the queue is empty. There is nothing inside the queue. What will happen? When the function gets called, it comes to this condition. It check the condition is count equals to max. Count is 0 because the initially the queue was empty. So it goes to the else part. It takes the first element. Then it immediately increments the rear pointer by 1. How it increments here? Initially, assuming that I'm writing here, rear equals to minus 1. It was first case. So what is happening here is rear equals to minus 1 plus 1 mod 5. So here it becomes 0 mod 5. Answer is 0 not able to divide this number. That's why it is zero only. It means the first value goes into index number zero. Okay, and then counter is incremented by one. So here count is equals to one. Introduce say value 10 at index number zero. Now again, suppose you perform the same operation on the circular queue, that is insertion operation. Here rear becomes zero when you insert this value, right? For the next calculation, it calculates rear pointer as 0 plus 1 mod 5. So I am telling you how this rear pointer, this formula is keeping our rear pointer in a circular fashion. So this is 1 mod 5 and the answer is 1. It means the next value must go into the next block, that is at index number 1, and the counter is incremented by 1, counter is 2, value inserted is say 20 in the next block. After inserting this, your rear was at 1. Again, suppose in the third iteration you execute the same code and you want to insert one more time, one more value inside the queue. So it means third value you are inserting, that is 30. Your rear is calculated as 1 plus 1 mod 5. Here it becomes 2 mod 5 and the answer is 2. Count is incremented by 1 after inserting the next value, that is say value that you are inserting is 30. Like this, after inserting that, your rear was pointing to 2. Again, try to insert till the queue becomes full. So rear for next calculation will be 2 plus 1 mod 5 and that becomes 3 mod 5. Answer is 3. Your count value is incremented by 1 because you are inserting one more element inside the queue. Value equals to 40. After assigning the value inside the queue, then we increment the counter. Okay. Here, rear when inserted 40, rear was pointing to 3. We want to insert one more element. Rear equals to now 3 plus 1 mod 5. It becomes 4 mod 5 equals to 4. Here, count becomes 5. And the next value that coming into the queue is say value is 50, and your rear is reached to rear pointer is reached to the last index, that is fourth index. Now if you see, all the blocks are filled with the elements 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. We are assuming that the size of the queue is 5. It means that last index, which was 4 of this queue, first index is 0, last index is 4. It is also filled with the value 50. Now what will happen? Can we insert one more element into this queue? No, because your counter is raised to 5. Correct? Counter variable is raised to 5. That is the maximum size of the queue. If you perform display operation, it will show you 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 as it is the way we displayed in linear queue. But what is different into this is, if I try to delete one element from the queue using DQ operation, what will happen? Now I want to perform DQ operation. In DQ operation, initially your front pointer was pointing to minus 1. In our previous example also, front was at minus 1 only. Now we are perform DQ operation. Front pointer comes into the picture only when we perform DQ operation. Here, front is calculated by the formula front equals to 1 plus 1, that is minus 1 plus 1 mod 5. This is the formula to calculate front value, correct? So front equal to front plus 1 mod max size, and we are doing the calculation here, and we found that 0 mod 5 equals to 0. It means that the first element which goes from the queue is 10, which is our index number 0 having the value 10. Index 0 having value 10 is now deleted. Where is your rear pointer? It is at the last index, which is 4. Now the first block is empty. I will try to delete. After deleting 10, your front becomes 0 and count becomes, count is decremented by 1, count becomes 4. Previously it was 5. Now you deleted what? One element from the queue, the front element, that is 10. That's why your counter becomes 4. Front, after this, all this calculation is at 0. For the next DQ operation, suppose you want to do DQ operation one more time on this. So how the front is calculated? 0 plus 1 mod 5 equals to 1 mod 5, that is 1. So the next element which gets deleted equals to 20, and then counter is decremented by 1, which is now 3, and your front pointer is at, front is at 1. After deleting 20, front is at 1. Now my question to you is, now if you see there are only 3 elements remain, that is 30, 40 and 50 in this circular queue. Can I insert one more element into this queue? How many elements I can insert further? I can insert 2 more elements because 2 memory blocks are empty now. So I can utilize those 2 blocks by inserting 2 more elements into this queue. Now how it will get the next index, because our rear is reached to the max size. If you see in this particular statement, when you inserted 50, the available elements are 30, 40, 50 now. 2 elements have been deleted, 10 and 20 is deleted. Your rear is pointing to the last index, that is 4, at having the value 50. Now to the next index for insertion, I will apply the same formula. Now I am inserting 60 into this queue. Rear is 4 for this calculation. How to calculate the next index? Rear equals to 4 plus 1 mod 5. That is 5. That is 5. Correct. It becomes 5 mod 5, and the answer is 0. It means that you can insert. It is telling the compiler that now you can insert the element in number 0. It is possible only when some blocks are empty. You can go back to the index number 0 and you can insert the elements. So this is the formula which actually keeping this rear variable in a circular fashion. So here I am inserting. Now before inserting that model, I need to pass the value. Say value is 60. So whenever you insert 60, count again is incremented by 1. It becomes 4. And you insert it, say value 60 in the queue. Again, there is one more block empty, index number 1. I can insert one more value into this. So after inserting this value 60, rear becomes 0. Now to get the next location for insertion, I will apply the formula again. Rear equals to 0 plus previous rear value plus 1 mod 5, and that goes to 1 mod 5. The answer is 1. So if I insert 70, say, then counter again becomes 5. Count becomes 5, and say I inserted the value 17 inside the queue. After inserting 70, rear is pointing to 1. Rear is pointing to 1. Correct. So can I insert one more element into this queue? Now if you see, there are elements 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. 5 elements are there. 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, we are able to now insert the values at the index 0 as well as at index number 1 by using the formula rear equals to rear plus 1 mod max. We are able to go back to the previous index in circular fashion because of this formula. So this is possible in circular queue. I'll go back to the code now. We run the hand run and we successfully check how it is being done in circular queue. Now we'll move to the another operation of queue, that is BQ operation. See, in BQ operation, as I said, in the hand run, we'll again check the empty condition for circular queue, that is queue underflow condition. How do you check? If count equals to 0, you can directly say that queue is empty. Else, just increment front pointer by 1 by this formula. You apply this formula to increment front pointer by 1 because it's circular queue. Do not just increment front by 1. You have to apply this formula. Q dot front equal to Q dot front plus 1 mod max. So this formula not only increments front pointer by 1 but also keeps the front pointer in a circular fashion. Then after incrementing front pointer by 1, you can say that the element deleted is %d and it is at array location or queue location q dot x of q dot front. So always the front element is picked and it is deleted from the queue. As soon as you are deleted that element, immediately decrement the counter by 1. So the next line after displaying the element deleted elements, the next line is count minus minus. So it will decrement count by 1. It will decrement count by 1. The major operation into this circular queue implementation is display. How do you display the all the elements of the circular queue? Can we use the same function that we used in linear queue? Students, consider this example that we have seen. We have inserted 5 elements successfully, 10, 30, 20, 30, 40, 50. Then we deleted 2 elements, 10 and 20 gets deleted. The remaining elements are 20, 30, 40 in the queue. After that, we found that there are 2 blocks empty. So we inserted 2 more elements, that is 60, 70. Now again the circular queue becomes full and the existing elements of the queue are 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. Now my question to you is, how to apply display function, how to write a code for display function so that it will display all the elements of the circular queue. Now if you see in this case, where is your rear pointer? It is at index number 1. After inserting value 70, your rear pointer is raised to 1, whereas your front pointer was at 1. When we deleted 20, it was raised to 1. You see here, front was 1 as well as rear was 1. Now tell me the code to display all the elements of the queue. It should follow the principle of FIFO, first in, first out. So it means that when you apply display function, the result must be 30, 40, 50, 60, and last element displayed is 70. Anyone can write the code and type the code in the chat box. How to display all the elements of this queue? Have you got my question, students? Hello? You can write your code in the chat box to display all the elements of the circular queue. The function has to be modified a little bit, then only we can able to display all the elements of the circular queue. We cannot copy as it is function that we did in linear queue implementation, display function of linear queue. we have to do some modification in such a way that it will display all the elements of this circular cube. In this example, both the pointers are pointing to at location number 1, index number 1. Front is at 1, rear is at 1. And your task is to display the elements. Can you write the code for display operation of circular cube? Tushar, Rutuja, are you able to do this code? I got some answers. First answer I got it from Shreya Bijam. For I equals to 0, I less than count, I plus plus. No, it will not work because your value of front is at 1 and rear is at 1. You have to consider all the possible cases. It may happen that the rear pointer is greater than front. Whenever rear is greater than front, we have to apply certain different code. Whenever front is greater than rear, then we have to apply some another code. We have to consider both the possibilities. Tushar has written something. I equal to front, okay. I less than count, okay. Then I equal to I plus 1 mod max. So you are incrementing I in a circular fashion. It may work. But again, what I'm telling you is, there are two cases in the display operation where in the first case, your rear pointer is greater than front, then there is different code for display all the elements. If the front pointer is greater than rear pointer, then you have to apply some different code for it. Okay, I'll show you the code and then we'll check the code on the compiler. We'll execute the code. Okay, Rutuja has written something. Integer I equal to front plus plus q dot front. While I not equal to q dot front. Printf percentage d q of x of I. Okay, I equal to I plus 1 mod max. Okay, I think this will work. This will also work like Tushar's code. But what I'm telling you is you have to consider two cases in display operation. One is if rear is greater than front, then how to display. If front is greater than rear pointer, then how to display the elements of the cube. Okay, I'll show you the code, display operation code. In the display operation, again, we need to check with the cube underflow condition by using this. If count equals to 0, again, if it is true, then we can say that the cube is empty. If it is not empty, then if the queue has the elements, then there are two possibilities. The first possibility is your rear pointer of the queue is greater than front pointer. Then how to display the elements? Just write the for loop in a forward direction. You go from front and you go till, you start with front and it goes till rear. So as in our example, if you see, we deleted 20, after deletion of 20, front is at 1. I need to add 1 to get the actual location of next element, that is 30 in the circular cube. Now to get that, we use the formula q dot front plus 1 here. I equal to q dot front plus 1, immediate next element, that is 2 now in this program. So it will start with 2. It will go to till the last index of the queue and it will display those elements. But this is not the case in our example. In our example, both the pointers are pointing to the same index. So it goes to the else part. It goes to the else part. So this will execute only when this if statement will be executed if this condition is true, and this code is executed only when if rear is greater than front. Otherwise, it goes to the else part. And there are two. The entire circular queue is divided into two half now. The first for loop will display all the elements of the queue from front to max minus one. That is the last index of the array. That is the last index of the queue. Whereas the second half circle of the queue will display another half of the queue. The another for loop will display all the elements from zero to rear. So the first for loop will display from front to max minus one. Another for loop will display from zero to rear. It will complete the whole circle. Correct. So I'll show you the code by executing it on a compiler. I have executed and I have entered the screenshot in this program. So if you just check this, after successfully executing, you'll get a screen. The compiler will ask you to enter. So we inserted 10 first, then again we inserted 20, then again insertion operation is done. So the size of the queue is 5, so I am inserting 5 more elements, total elements. 5 elements are inserted, say. So we have inserted 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Now, again, I want to insert one more element, that is 60. Is it possible on this full queue? No. It will show you the message that the queue is full. Then to check how many elements are there inside the queue, I executed option number 3. So I enter the option as 3, enter your choice as 3. So when you insert 3, it will display all the elements of the queue in the same manner in which they inserted 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. Now we'll try to perform DQ operation and we'll try to delete 10 and 20 from this queue. That's why I inserted value 2, enter your choice as 2. Element deleted is now, you can see on the screen, this 10 is deleted. To check it inside the queue, whether it is deleted or not, I again checked it by display operation by entering the choice number 3. It is showing me that the element 10 is not displaying. The elements existing are 20, 30, 40, 50 only. Now I try to perform delete 20 by applying the choice number 2. So I inserted choice 2. When I put choice 2, again the element is deleted. 20 has been deleted. Again, to check whether 20 is deleted or not, I check it by using display function. It is showing me that there are 3 elements now, 30, 40, 50. But it's a circular key. I can insert 2 more elements till this queue becomes full. If it was the linear queue, then we are not able to insert. We were not able to insert any value inside the queue. But in circular queue, it is possible. Here 2 values are deleted and now the 2 spaces are available for further insertion. So again, I enter the choice as 1. We insert the next element, 60. So it is successfully inserted. Then again, I will insert one more element, that is 70. It allows me to insert 70 also. It means that 2 more elements have been successfully inserted. To check it by option number 3, I can check it whether the elements have been inserted successfully or not. So I found that 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 have been successfully inserted. Now, again, if I try to insert one more element, that is 80, it is not possible because queue is full. Queue is full, right? And I exit from the program by entering the option number 4. So this program has been tested on my machine. This successfully working. Now the last point in this circular queue is, what are different applications of circular queue? Whenever there is something which is happening in a loop, one after the other, round robin fashion, you can say, you can use circular queue. Computer controlled traffic signal system uses a circular queue. Then CPU scheduling and memory management also uses circular queue. You are going to study these concepts in your operating systems. There you are going to study different algorithms of CPU scheduling. In that, we are going to use round robin algorithm of shedding, which uses circular key. Okay, so these are certain applications of circular key. This is the end of this concept of circular key. If you have any doubt in circular key, you can ask me now. Any questions, students, on circular key? Or I'll change my question now. Have you understood circular queue?